moving from 3 space to 2 space, we're going to lose all depth information. This is no surprise to us. We're accustomed to it. If you take a picture of me, my 3-dimensional head becomes 2-dimensional. But the immersion from my 3-dimensional head into 2 space, the flat screen that I'm projected onto, loses all information of the back of my head, and some part of my head becomes an edge. So a photograph is a 2-dimensional immersion of a 3-dimensional object. Well, a Klein bottle is a manifold that really is 4-dimensional. And it's a fairly accurate representation of a Klein bottle almost everywhere. Almost everywhere. Well, not really, because, first of all, it has a thickness. Glass has a thickness. It's also not a perfect Klein bottle, because a perfect Klein bottle not only has zero thickness, but its size is undefined until Mr. Ryman's metric is defined on it. To move this from 4 dimensions to 3, it has to self-intersect. This self-intersection is a result of it being an immersion. There's several ways to do that, to cause this self-intersection to happen. One, the way I do it is to bend the glass around, make a ring weld here, make a ring weld there, make a weld here so that it's possible to pour water in or make a connection through here and get from the outer universe to the sort of inside. Can you put water in a Klein bottle? You betcha, in our physical universe. Yeah, I got that. But there's other ways to do it. So I talked to George Chittenden over at Adams and Chittenden Glass. George says, let me at it. So he said, another way to do it, to make this almost reach there, and this intersection almost reach there. This is a valid immersion of a Klein bottle. I can go here. I can push this up. Oops. And you can kind of see that it doesn't touch. This immersion allows an ant to walk around here everywhere, but it adds 2 edges. 1, 2, that don't exist in the original Klein bottle. The original Klein bottle has no edges in one side. This has 1 side, but 2 edges. What's been lost from the true Klein bottle into here is 2 edges have been introduced, and it's no longer connected from inside to outside.
What advantage does it have over your...
This has the huge advantage, as George Chittenden said, of being slightly easier to make. But then George says, well, maybe I could try doing another one where instead of having the break here, let's make the break along here. Here we have the neck going all the way through and a large hole around here. Let's see if I can show that hole. Okay, hope that shows. There's a hole that George burnt into the side of the Klein bottle, and he brings this tube right through it.
That's kind of what you do in the other one, except that hole then shrinks to touch it, doesn't it?
Correct. Exactly right, Brady. In my normal Klein bottle, I'll shrink this hole until it touches what a glass blower would call a ring weld. However, these are slightly different. For example, here, this is a genuine edge. If the glass becomes arbitrarily thin, this becomes razor sharp. Here, it's not an edge. Rather, it's a place where the manifold has multiple definitions at one point. Here, on this Klein bottle, every point is properly defined in the entire manifold. Here, that's almost true, except around the circle of singularities, each point is defined as, it might be part of this, or it might be part of this. So I can scootle this. And this one, I can also scootle in. However, this hole is a different approach to having an immersion. Finally, George says, well, you know, we could do it so that we demonstrate that the surface of the bottle is continuous even along here. Problem that this has is there's a hole on the inside. So he put a window in there, so it almost looks like this. However, there's a glass window that prevents a connection between here and there. So in a sense, this manifold is continuous across here and continuous across here, but it still has the self-intersection of a normal Klein bottle. All of these are different immersions of the same thing. The point is, you take a picture of my face, or you can take a picture from behind me or from over here and from up there, you're going to get a different view. None of them are completely accurate. Is this a completely accurate picture of Felix Klein? No, I can't tell what the back of his head is like. I don't know how many ears he has. I know he's got one ear. I can extrapolate to say he's got a second ear. The three-dimensional human being can't be seen in a two-dimensional photograph. The nature of an immersion. Of course, with all these different immersions of the Klein bottle, my friend Lucas Clark came by. He said, Cliff, I've got another approach. Lucas looked at a Coca-Cola bottle and he said, I'm going to turn it into a Klein bottle. And is that possible to see that this is the very end of the, this is where the cap goes? He's drawn the neck of the Klein bottle through a hole. Mind you, he has made a hole like this guy here. And he's drawn the neck through and welded the lip of the Coke bottle to the base of the Coke bottle. What's astonishing about this is not just the mathematical immersion, but glass people will recognize that this is a borosilicate glass, meaning that it's a very low expansion glass. All my Klein bottles are boros, and it allows you to heat one area without heating the entire thing. Borosilicate is relatively easy to work with. It's called hard glass because it doesn't expand much with temperature. It's less likely to crack. This is Coke bottle glass. It's the cheapest soda lime glass that the Coca-Cola company can find. Lucas bent all of this using soda lime glass, which is really impressive. But wait, there's even more impressiveness about it. He was able to do all of this glass work and preserve the paint on it. Notice, glass blowers can put labels on glass using a ground up ceramic called a ceramic frit. Coca-Cola doesn't use a frit. They just spray paint it on or screen it on. Lucas Clark not only was able to drill the hole, but he was able to preserve the label and do all of this glass work while retaining that it's a Coca-Cola bottle.
That's the actual original top that he's threaded through the hole.
Yes, it is, but I suspect that he welded another piece onto here. In other words, I suspect, but I don't know. He didn't. Lucas keeps secrets from me. I suspect that he put an additional, maybe, 30 centimeters of Coca-Cola bottle glass to make this work. But I'm not going to ask his secrets. There's some things I don't want to know. And held underwater long enough.
So you're doing like a sort of a 360, are you, to get the bubble up?
Yeah. This hole has got to be the same as this hole.
Oh my